What's going on, guys? Crazy Pete's Man 21. Today we got some exciting news from Game Informer. They recently just announced that they have a Resident Evil 4 issue coming out. They released a pretty dope cover of it. I'm gonna put up over here. And we also got some more exclusive gameplay of it. Looks like we got a little bit of footage from the church. They said that they got time to play chapter 1 and chapter 5, so I assume that they're getting rid of the 1-1, 1-2 kind of chapter breakdown.
We visited Capcom's headquarters in Osaka, Japan to play chapter 1 and 5.
But that's fine, so I guess there are going to be chapters then. I guess they kind of inadvertently confirmed in the trailer. And then we also got a really cool look at the church. Really quick, if you pause, you can notice there's the stained glass window puzzle that was in the original. Looks like that's going to be making a comeback. While all the cultists kind of storm out of the church, it looks like there's definitely more of a siege element aspect they're adding, where the church comes under siege, possibly from the Ganados, rather than after when you're leaving, going back towards the village. And then we also got to see what it looks like when Ashley gets grabbed, pretty similar to the original, except now there's a little like icon over her that lets you know, besides just her being taken. I mean, the original also gave an icon over her health bar, but now I guess you have an actual one over where she is, which is, I guess, a little bit helpful. And it looks like you can just easily just come up behind him, stab him, instead of having to, like, really meticulously aim and shoot, making sure you don't hit her so you don't kill her anymore. So that looks like a great improvement already. And also, if you notice, there's been a big change to the quick change slots on the D-pad, where rather than just having four options, it looks like you can now add multiple items into the quick slot, more than four. You could have, like, you know, obviously the regular four, and then like double click a certain direction on the D-pad to get even more guns. And I think that's a really great addition, because it looks like they're speeding up the gameplay a little bit, so it looks like it's pretty exciting and adds more to the chaos, because you don't have to keep going into your inventory now to change guns and stuff. And speaking of guns, if you also look really closely, it looks like we have a custom scope on the sniper. And I don't know if you guys noticed this in one of the other trailers they released, was that the sniper, I think, don't quote me on it, it's just a speculation, that the sniper might come without a scope this time. And we already knew the original Resident Evil 4 had different scopes for the snipers and stuff like that. And it looks like that's also coming back, and maybe there'll be more attachments for guns and stuff like that. We also see the Red9 come back, so we know, really, it seems like all the fan favorites are returning. They even added a new enemy to the game. There's a friggin' goat head dude with a hammer. This guy might be to change it up from just seeing the chainsaw, you know, Mr. Dr. Salvador all the time. And then see some gameplay of Leon fighting him. And we also see what the dogs are going to look like, the infected dogs. And dude, this is just all looking really, just really amazing. And it's so awesome that Game Informer got to share all this with us. So I want to know what you guys think in the comments. What are you most excited for? So we're not only seeing that most of the original game is already intact, but also they're adding more enemies and stuff to the game. This is honestly looking like to be the best remake possibly since the remake of 1. Who knows? All I know is this game is gearing up to look really cool, and it looks really, really exciting, and I'm excited to see where they go with it. I just wanted to quickly talk about it because it looks friggin' amazing. And it looks like Game Informer is going to release a little bit more later on this week for the people that are subscribed to them, so I might honestly even pick up a subscription for the first time in a very long time. And either way, I'll probably pick up the latest issue from GameStop if they still even sell them. Either way, I'm going to be covering more of it, so if you guys like stuff like this, be sure to check out the channel. I'll be posting more Resident Evil 4 news and also some tips and tricks on games. So, yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you all have a very blessed day, and see you next time.